Hello there, you beautiful children. I am Bushra. And today we are going to start a new lesson in literature, that is the tale of Peter Rabbit. So before I begin with the story, let us first see what the story is all about. So this story, The Tale of Peter Rabbit by Beatrix Potter, is a well-loved story for children. And even in class 3rd, you all might have studied about Peter Rabbit and the Reddy Fox. So, you know, this is the story which is in every book or, in each grade, because children like listening to these stories. It's all humorous, and these stories about Peter Rabbit is that, the rabbit is actually a very mischievous one. Okay. So in this story, The Tale of Peter Rabbit also, the story narrates the tale of a naughty rabbit, Peter, and he never listens to his mother. In spite of his mother's warning, he ventures into Mr. Mac Granger's garden to feast on the vegetables there. Mother said not to go to the garden and, have the vegetables. Then also, this rabbit went to Mr. Mac Granger's garden. And, however, Mr. Mac Granger spots him, finds him, and then he, chases him. Then what happened, Peter runs for his life and with great difficulty makes it back to the safety of his rabbit hole. Okay, so mother said him not to go to the garden. Then also he went there, and the man, Mr. Mac Granger, when he found a rabbit there, he started chasing him, and the rabbit, with a lot of difficulty, he found the way to his home, to his hole, and there he, he was totally relaxed. So his family cares for him. She feeds unwell after the incident, and Peter apologizes to his mother for ignoring her warning. Okay, so this is the story, and we will be learning more about it in the next few slides. So let us quickly begin. So once upon a time, four little rabbits, Flopsy, Mopsy, Cottontail, and Peter, they lived with their mother. So you can see Flopsy, Mopsy, Cottontail, and Peter, you have four rabbits. They lived with their mother in a sandbank underneath the root of a big fir tree. So what happened? Once upon a time, there were four rabbits, Flopsy, Mopsy, Cottontail, and Peter. They lived on the sandbank. So what is a sandbank? So have a look, deposit of sand on the river bank. So actually what happens when a river is flowing, it carries, the small sand and the rocks, small rocks, okay, the particles. And, when the speed of the river becomes slow, at that time, all the sediments and the sands that it's carrying, it deposits it on the river bank. Okay, that is the sand bank. So on the sand bank, underneath the root of a big fir tree. Underneath means, below. And, rabbits, they live inside the holes, burrows. Okay. So, underneath the big fir tree, under the root of the big fir tree, these four rabbits, along with their mother, they used to live there. So, one day what happened? The mother rabbit, she told the other rabbits, that run along, my dears. Just play. But remember, don't get up to any mischief, but remember that you don't do any mischief, and don't go into Mr. Mac Granger's garden. So she said, you all can run and play, but don't do any mischief and all, and don't go to the garden. Whose garden? Mr. Mac Granger's garden. Now, so Flopsy, Mopsy, and Cottontail, they always listened to their mother, and they went to gather blackberries. So said, okay, let us collect these fruits. So they went to collect the blackberries. Flopsy, Mopsy, and Cottontail. Who is left now? Peter Rabbit is left now. So Peter, mama told not to go there. So Peter ran straight to Mr. Mac Granger's garden, where he ate some lettuce and some French beans. Okay. So he went there, and what he did is that he ate some lettuce. Okay, these green leaves. And after that, he ate some French beans also. Then, feeling a little sick, he went to look for some parsley. Okay, so he ate the lettuce, He ate some French beans and then he started feeling sick. So he went to look for some parsley. And children, like parsley, what is it? It is a small herb. Okay? And like, in Hindi we call it ajwain, and it is having lots of health benefits. So he started feeling sick, so he thought ki, okay, let me go and buy and look for some parsley leaves. Okay? Then what happened? So he thought of this. And then what happened? Just around the end of a cucumber frame, he saw Mr. MacGregor, who angrily jumped up and ran after him. Stop thief, that is what he said. What happened? He thought, ki, okay, like he went to look for some parsley leaves, and like he was crossing the cucumber frame. Okay, there he saw Mr. MacGregor coming, and Mr. MacGregor was very angry. Why? Because this rabbit, he ate some lettuce, French beans, and now some parsley leaves as well. So he was very angry and he started running after him. He asked Peter Rabbit to stop and he even called him a thief. And Peter Rabbit, he was like incredibly frightened, like extremely frightened. And he started running as fast as he could around the garden, trying to find the back way to the gate. Okay? Like from where he could escape. He started finding a different gate. Then what happened? While he was running and he was trying to figure out where the back door is, okay, and he was trying to escape, he ran into a gooseberry net and got caught by the large buttons on his new red jacket. So what happened? Like, near the gooseberry plant, a net was there. And while he was trying to escape, Peter Rabbit had, like he was wearing a new jacket. And on his jacket, there were, large buttons. So what happened? These buttons got stuck in these nets. Okay, in these nets. And, if the buttons are stuck, what will happen? The rabbit will automatically get stuck in this, what to say, in this net itself. He won't be able to run. Okay? Then what happened? Mr. MacGregor came up with the wreck. But Peter wriggled out of his jacket just in time and took off across the garden again. So what he thought of is that, his jacket was caught inside the net. What he did, he saw, okay, Mr. MacGregor is following me. And the moment Mr. MacGregor was about to reach, what he did is that he just threw off his jacket. Okay, let the jacket be with the net, and he just rushed out. Okay, so that is what he did. And then what happened? Like he started running, and Peter Rabbit rushed into a tool shed and jumped into a can that was unfortunately full of water. What happened while he was running? He saw a can was there. He just, jumped inside it. And he saw the, oh, like it was full of water. Then what happened? Mr. MacRoger was quite sure that Peter was somewhere in the tool shed, like where all the tools are there for gardening purpose. So he went inside that, he saw a can is there, he jumped into it, and unfortunately it was full of water. But Mr. MacGregor, he saw that the rabbit has gone inside the tool shed. But where, like so many things are there inside the tool shed, where did he actually go? Mr. MacGregor didn't know about it, but he was sure that the rabbit is somewhere there inside it only. So Mr. MacGregor was quite sure that Peter was somewhere in the tool shed, perhaps hidden under a flower pot. He thought that, rabbit might be hiding, below any flower pot something. So he carefully turned them over, looking under each one. Okay, so like you can see in the image here. So what he is doing, he's just like picking each flower pot and he's seeing the rabbit is hiding or not, rabbit is hiding or not. And then what happened? Peter sneezed. Okay, and the moment, like Curtis coo, something like this. So this kind of a, the Curtis coo, this kind of sound comes out, when the rabbit sneezes. So the moment the rabbit sneezed, MacGregor, just figured out where the voice was coming from. And then Mr. MacGregor was soon after him. And he again tried to catch Peter. And this time Peter jumped out of a window. Okay. Then the window was too small for Mr. MacGregor. And he was tired of running after Peter. Mr. McGregor was following him since from that cucumber frame. Okay. And the rabbit could escape from the small window, but how will that big man escape? He couldn't escape. And on top of that, Mr. McGregor was also very tired because he was running after Peter since a long time. Right? Now, what this rake is, as I said over here, Mr. McGregor came up with a rake. 1 second. This one. Yeah. Mr. McGregor came up with a rake, but Peter wriggled out of his jacket just in time and took off across the garden again. So I think over here you can see the rake. Okay. So what this rake is? Rake is a tool to remove leaves from the ground. So you can see, the sharp edges over here, they are used to remove the leaves from the ground. So Mr. McGregor was carrying this. Okay. So we were over here. So what happened? The rabbit went out from the window, and the window was too small for Mr. McGregor to escape or to run after him. Now Peter Rabbit moved from one place to the other, looking for the gate. But he just lost his way. Because he ran so much, he just couldn't keep in track, what the correct way is. So Peter Rabbit moved from one place to the other, looking for the gate. Unfortunately, he had lost his way and could not get out of the garden. So he was there inside the garden only. Okay. And he was trying to find, garden was extremely big. He was trying to find where the gate is so that, he can escape from here. Otherwise, Mr. McGregor will again, catch him. Then what happened? Okay. So, he asked a rat for the direction. So, see, a rat is there. He asked the rat, in the garden, many animals used to live. So, what happened? He asked, ma'am, can you tell me the way to the main road? So, this rat madam, she said, no, I can't. Then what happened? He even asked a cat. Now, cat said, don't disturb me, I'm busy. And no one was there to help him out. Suddenly, he saw Mr. McGregor. What he was doing? He was hying his onion patch. Hying means to take out the onions, okay? Digging and taking it out. Using a tool called hye to turn over the soil in the garden. Okay, so using this tool, what happens is that, the soil is being turned and the onions, they're just removed from the soil properly. So he saw him in the onion patch, and just beyond him was the gate. Okay, now Peter, he sprinted across the onion patch and slipped under the gate. He saw Mr. McGregor in the onion patch and he saw the door beyond that. So somehow, he has to escape from there. So he sprinted. So what do you mean by sprinted? He sprinted across the onion patch. What do you mean by sprinted? Sprinted means, to run at an extremely fast speed. If the distance is very small and, you're just running quickly. So that is how Peter Rabbit, he just sprinted across the onion patch so that Mr. McGregor doesn't notice him. And then he said, and he slipped under the gate. Okay. So that, if this is the gate and a little space was there. So from here, he just slipped out. Okay. And then he said, thank God I found the gate. Let me run home to mother. He has ran so much. Peter flopped down on the nice soft sand on the floor of the rabbit hole and shut his eyes. He ran and ran. And when he reached his home, okay, the soft sand the soft sand that was there on the floor. We were talking about the sand bed where they used to live. So Peter came here and when he reached, he just lay down and closed his eyes. He felt safe and secure. Okay. Then what happened? So and he shut his eyes. So mother said, why? Peter, what's the matter? Then Peter Rabbit said, I got lost in Mr. McGregor's garden. I'm sorry, mother. I should have listened to your warning. He was there. Mr. MacGregor, he chased him, and due to this, you know, he just forgot, he just lost his way. For that, you know, again, he had to run, and it took a lot of time to figure out the way. And finally, he returned to his home. He felt safe and secure. He was extremely tired. And although, you know, we read in the beginning that, you know, he was not feeling well. After eating, you know, the lettuce and the French beans, he was not feeling well. He was not feeling well. On top of that, he ran so much. He lost his way. He figured the direction. And finally, he reached. Okay. So he said, yeah, like, you know, like, I'm sorry to say it, Peter. So he said, sorry, like, you know, Peter Rabbit said, sorry, like, you know, Mama, I won't do this again. I should have listened to your warning. And then the author is saying, the one who has written the story, that I'm sorry to say that Peter was not very well that night. That night he was sick. His mother put him to bed and made him some tea. Flopsy, Mopsy and Cottontail had bread, milk, blackberries for the supper. Okay, so what happened? That night when they were having their meal, since he was ill, Peter was ill, that is the reason he only had some tea, that's it. Okay, and he was there on his bed. He couldn't do any mischief. But the other three who just followed the warnings, Flopsy, Mopsy and Cottontail, they had bread, milk and blackberries. Okay, so who was there, like, you know, like this Peter Rabbit, now he didn't gain anything. He just ate few lettuce, few French berries, and then what happened? He became sick as well. He ran so much, and at the end of the day, he just got tea to drink. On the other hand, the other three, they just followed all the instructions. They gathered the blackberries. They ate the blackberries at night along with bread and milk. Fine? So this is the story about Peter Rabbit. Okay, I hope, like, you know, you have understood the story. If you haven't, read the story twice and thrice, watch the video twice and thrice, make sure, you know, everything is clear to you. And if it's not, do get in touch with me. Okay, we will meet in the next video. Until then, take care. God bless. Thank you.